Bonjour, welcome to Meetup Gamer Pizzeria. Today we will be making a fantastic pizza, maybe more than one, we will have to see. So today we will start with a normal pizza to start, one of my favorite pizzas. So we will choose a round crust, because we're not animals, we will not choose the square ones. It's very kind of weird for a square pizza, so we'll go with a round pizza. To start there, ah yes. The tomato sauce, the classic sauce that goes on the pizza. Now the first thing we should do is always put the pepperoni before. So first we have to find the pepperoni. Let's go with salami because that's the only one that can look almost like a pepperoni. All right. Now we must put a lot of salami. We must cover the entire pizza. Not too far on the crust. Then it does not taste good. The cheese will not melt properly. I have to make sure that we do this very well. A little bit at a time. Might as well do some video magic and fast forward this pepperoni insertion mode. Okay, we are done with this salami slash pepperoni. Now we will add the cheese. We will go with the classic cheese that we put on the pizza. The mozzarella. We must put a lot of mozzarella. Alright, we must make sure there is some everywhere. Those little white demons must be everywhere on the pizza. Yes, everywhere. Let's keep spreading nice and thinly. So we want an even golden crust. So we have to make sure we also put some a bit on the crust. That's what makes the nice, nice soft crust, nice and crunchy. And now we will do the rest of the pizza, making sure we slightly almost do not see the rest of the pizza. Nice and slowly. And yes, we are done. What we'll do, we will go and do my favorite kind. We'll do a meat lover's pizza. So, we already got the salami, we will put now the bacon. Since we are carnivores, we will put a nice big slices of bacon. Nice big slices of bacon. It will cook in the stove, don't worry. It looks kind of uncooked now, but it will be fine after we cook it. Now we will put some ham to complete the nice meat lover's pizza. Little bit of ground beef. Not too much, because too much is disgusting. Like I said, it's not cooked yet. Don't worry. Okay. A bit of sausage, of course. Usually a bit thinner cut than this, but this is not my restaurant. We will try this way. And now we will finish with a touch of spice. Yes, the chili powder. The chili flakes, it's even better. Splish, 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 splish. A little clicky. Magnifique. La pizza is ready. Spicy meat lovers pizza. Magnifique. The price for the pizza is $97. Perfect price for a meat lover pizza. Okay, let's try a different pizza. I will satisfy the square pizza lover, but we will make them that pizza extremely well for their taste. Let's go to ingredients, of course, the tomato sauce to start. What would a pizza person that likes square pizza put on the base under the cheese? Let's go in the meats. Okay, so since we will be doing a square pizza, we'll go what I assume is the favorite ingredient of the person that loves a square pizza, and we'll put the ants at the base, because I'm assuming they are monsters eating square pizza. So let's start with ants. Can we go bigger? Bigger. Yes, the perfect size of ant. Pretty much we had to kill a lot of colonies for this pizza. Yes. Like the monsters they are for eating a square pizza, they will enjoy this very much. Of course, we have to put, since they are very disgusting people, eating square pizza, we will put gongola cheese that is too big, even for those animals. Still too big for those monsters. Let's put gongola for those monsters eating square pizza. Okay, let's make it nice. At least something looks nice on it with the gongola. Alright, now we will do the topping of the pizza. Of course, we will put grasshoppers, because why not? Let's just spread it evenly. We don't want to choke those monsters to choke on their disgusting square pizza. Yes, very good. Very good. Maggots, of course. I'm assuming they eat those for breakfast usually, but let's put some a bit on their pizza. This is a good pizza for breakfast, for lunch, for dinner, or whatever time people that eat square pizza come out to eat. I'm assuming they have to open the manhole cover before coming out. Of course, the main ingredient of our square pizza is le coquel. Of course, they very enjoy the coquel on their pizza. They usually just call it also coq. So let's put a bit of them, not too much, because the coquel can be quite spicy. Or salty, I mean. Ah yes, that looks very appetizing.
For a monster.
Of course, because we must treat them with respect, we will put caviar to make them feel important. At least they can feel a bit richer from eating the square pizza of a monster. Here, let's keep adding little babies everywhere of caviar. I'm assuming they are babies, they're eggs from a fish. Dead long extinct at this point, because they eat so much of them. And we will also add like very disgusting people anchovy. Because who the hell likes anchovy on the pizza? It's very disgusting. We'll just keep adding on this pizza. For one of the last ingredients, we will add jalapenos. Because we want those monsters to feel it coming out when it's time for the pooping time. And we don't want them to ever come again to our restaurant. We have something else in store for them to never come back after they eat this very appetizing pizza. And of course, the main ingredient and the last ingredient for a very special disgusting square pizza for people that are monsters, the pineapple, of course. We truly know everybody that put pineapple on their pizzas are truly monsters. We will top our pizza with that. Oh yes, the true signature of a real square pizza monster eater. Ah yes. Now the only thing we need now is the name for this pizza. First off, they will probably never come to the restaurant because the pizza cost $306. So this assures that the restaurant will never see one of those people here. Let's call it Square Monster Pizza People. Where is this? With a pineapple. Pineapple. I'm assuming that's how you write it. Ah yes, we have completed the perfect pizza. As you can see beside my head, the price is $306, the perfect price to never see these people in my restaurant. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the pizza creations I've created for you. Of course, I might try to create more fantastic pizza in my restaurant for you guys to enjoy. Tell me what kind of pizza, what suggestion for different kind of people you think would come to my restaurant, and what you want me to create my perfect creation of pizza for them. So thank you so much. Of course, like the video, subscribe to the channel, we really appreciate that. And of course, you can follow me everywhere, Meetime Gamer, at Meetime Gamer everywhere, Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, and on Facebook. And of course, right here, youtube.com/MeTimeGamer, where I post a new video every day of the week, Monday to Friday. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next marvelous creation video. Keep on keeping on.